Hey, would you like to learn how to create carousel posts for Instagram only using Canva? So we've all seen different kinds of posts like this, and honestly, I feel like it's been a trend on Instagram to create those carousel posts, so that's what we're going to be talking about today. So welcome back to my channel, Jelena Ostrovska here from jelenaostrovska.com. Super excited to see you back here if you are an old visitor, and if you are a brand new person we've never met before, be sure to consider subscribing. Hello, super pumped to see you here. This is the best place for coaches, consultants, and entrepreneurs who are trying to monetize their expertise on social media. So today we are talking all things content marketing, all things Instagram, and all things carousel posts on Instagram. Before we dive into the actual tutorial, what I do want to say is, like, the reason why carousel posts are becoming so popular. And here's the number one reason, and you have to understand the way Instagram algorithm works right now is way different than it used to be years ago, right? So we only used to have images and then 15 second clips on Instagram, and then they elaborated into 60 second clips, and now we have even Instagram Live and IGTV, and you can upload videos of up to an hour, which is amazing. And now we have those carousel posts that have only been implemented on Instagram. They're not on Facebook, they're not on Twitter, they're not anywhere else. The only place that I do know of that has carousel posts is Pinterest, but that's the topic for another time. Now, why do carousel posts work better than a regular post, and sometimes even better than a video? So any post that you create can be turned into a carousel post, and here's the reason why you do want to consider that. So imagine yourself scrolling through Instagram, right? So you scroll through the feed and then you keep seeing different posts, and then you see a carousel post that shows you the first image of that carousel, right? So you kind of see it, but then you don't really engage with it and you keep scrolling, and then you're like, okay, so I'm gonna, you know, get back to Instagram later. You get back to Instagram a couple hours later, you refresh your feed, you keep on scrolling, and then you see that same post, but you see the second image. So you see the second image of the carousel. So Instagram is giving more juice and more attention to the posts that have more than one image in that particular post, which is a carousel. So it can have two images, it can have up to 10 images. So now that you know that they do get more attention, that they do get more exposure on Instagram, now it's time to actually figure out how to make those. So we will have a separate video on kind of the psychology behind the carousel post. I feel like it's much needed, so let me know in the comments if that's something that you would want to see. But now let's dive into the tutorial on how to actually make it without having to be a graphic designer, without having any knowledge of Photoshop, without knowing Adobe or Lightroom or any of those fancy softwares that graphic designers are using. If you are a regular human being like myself, we are going to dive into Canva, and I'm also going to share with you how to make them seamless, because sometimes you scroll through the Instagram carousel and you see those like seamless images. Now, if you want to learn how to make those, let me show you.
Are inside of my Canva account. So what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and create a design. So, and there's a couple of options. You can just make an Instagram post and you can try to adjust everything. However, it's not always the best idea. And the problem with this is, I'm gonna show you right now. So let's say, let's just choose, as much as I don't wanna do this, let's choose one of those for COVID, because Instagram, Canva does have all these little templates right here. So I'm gonna go ahead and choose this one, right? So I'm gonna go ahead and copy the page. And what you can do is you can try to adjust. So let's say if this little icon, you basically can try to adjust it to where it's going to be seamless, but it's not going to be perfect, right? So the better way for you to do that is to go into the Canva account and choose custom dimensions in order for you to make the carousel look seamless. So, and you have to understand that on Instagram, you can make a carousel post of up to 10 images. So keep that in mind. So before you actually make your design, think about it. How many images do you want to include? Is it going to be 2? Is it going to be 4? Is it going to be 6? So And that way you can figure out how your design is going to look like the best. Maybe you're going to have the last image of your design that's going to be generic for every single one of them. So now what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and choose the size, and I'll give you the reason why you need to choose this kind of size, 2160 pixels by 1080. And the reason for that is you can see that the first, the width is twice as big compared to the height. And you're about to see why. And then we're going to switch over to my mobile and I'll show you how to crop it. So now you can see, so let me go ahead and make the background first. And we're going to go ahead and choose this color right here. Then I do want to go ahead and make a line. And we're just going to go ahead and keep it like this. And then I'm just going to make it 90 degrees so it's clean. And now I want to adjust it to the center. Right, and I'll explain to you why. Now you see that these are literally two pictures for Instagram. Right now, here's what we're going to do. So we're going to go ahead and create the text. So we're going to make it, let me see, uppercase. We're going to make it bigger because nobody can see under the microscope right here. So, and we're going to write down some text.
How to make a seamless Instagram carousel in Canva.
Now we're gonna just make it all look nice. I'm about to make it white. That's gonna look a little bit better. Now I'm gonna do all these little adjustments to make it look cleaner. Now I'm gonna blow it up a little bit right here. Now I do have some elements, so I'm gonna go ahead and choose this little arrow right here.
And we're gonna align it right here so people can literally like see.
Right, so I'm gonna make it white. Let's just keep it like this. And then I'm gonna put this little icon right here. Obviously, this is not perfect for this particular design, but I'll show you later on once we get to the editing how it's gonna all make sense and how it's all gonna be seamless. And especially, you're gonna see it by the arrow. Now, the next thing you can do is you can go ahead and again, we're gonna go ahead and duplicate it. So we're gonna adjust it to the other side, place it right here. Make sure that it's all centered, nice and clean. So you gotta love Canva for adjusting everything. And then you can just write something like,
it's very easy without you having to hire a graphic, if I can find a designer, and let's adjust it.
So something like this. Now this is all aligned. You can add different things, like you can search, for example, next, and you can add a little, you know, text right here so people actually, you know, scroll over. So that is totally up to you. You can change all these colors, make it bright. So now that the design is ready, let's jump into my phone and I'll show you how to crop it perfectly. But before I do, let me remove this line. So that's how our design is going to look as final. Okay, so now that I'm in my phone and I have my design saved, there's two different apps that you can use. You can use either Square Feet or you can use InShot. So it doesn't really matter. InShot is really good for videos as well. So let's wait for this ad to scroll. Now, what you want to do is you want to click on the bottom left icon called New. You choose Photo. And now I have the photo right here. Right? So I'm about to go ahead and click Crop in the middle. And then I want to choose Square. Now that this image size is perfect, so if I scroll all the way to the left, you see how this is touching the size, the side, just a little bit like this. And I'm gonna go ahead and click done, and we're gonna go ahead and click save. So that is saved. Now we are about to go ahead and pull up another one, and basically do the same thing. And now again, I click on crop. Choose square and push it all the way to the right. So now this is done, save, and then I'm gonna go over to Instagram, and if I choose this one, then I want to select the carousel, and now you see this is seamless. Obviously the brain is not perfectly aligned, but you see the arrow is perfect right there. You can do the same thing using the app called InShot. So all you have to do is just select the photo, and then you basically do the same thing, and you selected the same way possible, and you just
choose the crop option and choose the Instagram one and just drag it to this side, and it's going to do the same thing.
So there you go. That's how you make Instagram carousel posts and how you make them seamless using only Canva. If you enjoyed this tutorial, then be sure to hit that subscribe button, hit the bell sign down below this video, and check out these videos right here where I talk more about social media, about Instagram, about different tutorials, as well as Canva. And with that being said, I appreciate you. I hope this video was helpful, and I will see you in the next one. Bye.